finger.
That's how we do it.
Your
360. Tai Chi. Come forward, man.
I'm standing at a crossroads.
Flow
in. Facing life's railroads. I'm leaving indecision, man. With the silly superstitious plan. Quick schemes to big dreams. All your hustles get away from me. I'm seeking out the simple things. Like peace and longevity.
Hey, what's up, Bill? Come on in, fam. Let's get it.
Woo!
Tai Chi 360, baby. I'm excited, man. I'm excited, bro.
Hey, man, we changing people's lives, man. How could I not be happy about that, fam? I'm excited, man. Oh, man, put your seatbelt on, fam. We just taking flight. We just taking flight. Mm-hmm. Super excited. Glad to have you on board, family. Yes, I am. Let's let Soul Group come in.
Come on in, Soul Group. Let's get our Tai Chi.
Essential for all of us in the soul group. Go get that. Go get you one. Yes. Big shout out to Brother Santos. Soul Group, come on in. Let's go. Let's tie. Let's do it. Let's take flight. Let's take flight. Man, I'm so excited and so happy, man. I just keep getting more and more confirmation from... Let me get these tunes right. Getting more and more confirmation, man, from the community in regards to how beneficial, how helpful our practice has been helping people, man. We're really influencing people's lives here, family. This ain't no joke. This ain't no joke. This is no joke. I never knew what I wanted to grow up when I grew up. I never knew. I knew I love people. I love life, I love animals, I love plants, I love flowers, I love all forms of life. That's all I ever knew. Now, I chose some careers along the way. But they were never what I really wanted to do. Never. Come on in, fam. We just getting started. And now here we are literally, man, helping people to change their lives for the better. It don't get no better than that. Nobody ever told me that in school, that you can actually help people change their lives for the better. You can do that. I never knew it, family. And it's so simple. It's easy. It's easy. It's just a matter of just sharing your life. Share your life with other people. No degrees necessary. Don't need it. Don't need it. We're all skilled. How much I want everybody to be in here who's going to be in here, because this is serious business. Whenever this come out, this is serious business. I want the whole soul group to be in here, because we're getting into Tai Chi principles now. We're getting into the governing philosophy of the practice. We're getting into the governing philosophy of the practice, how to. The how to. Not what to, but how to. Mm-hmm. The way of life. How did you enjoy day number 70, Brother Gary? 70. How was your standing today? I know you said yesterday was a little rough. You said yesterday was a little rough, my brother. How is today? We got 10 people in here so far, 10 family members in here so far. How was your standing, my good brother? Been thinking about you. You said your back was giving you some concern, so of course I've been thinking about you, my brother. Mm-hmm. Brother Gary. Oh, good, man. Good. Glad to hear that. Super smooth today. Good. Maybe your body was going through something, making some adjustments, burning off some garbage, something didn't serve you well. You get me? Get what I'm saying? Like I told you, my shoulder was killing me that one day. 2 days. Woo. But I had to persevere. I had to see it through. I know y'all couldn't help me. Soul group couldn't help me with that. Could give me some words of encouragement, but I had to do it myself. Hey, let's jump in. This is Master Liao's teachings here. And this is his translation of the Tai Chi classic. So if you're studying Tai Chi, this is a mandatory reading if you're studying with me. Several students here in the soul group are practicing and studying with me. So you're going to want to pick this up. Yes, you are. I'm going to share one or two things with you. I'm not going to... And you can read this for years, family. I've been reading this for over 20 years. What page today, Brother Burke says? Brother Jeremy, this page 87, my brother. This is page 87, talking about Tai Chi classics. This is A Tree Steeds by Chan Song Fong. Have you all heard of Chan Song Fong? He's a Tai Chi legendary. A Tai Chi legendary. Page 87. Tai Chi classics of the legendary. I didn't even know it was there. I just said it. He's a Tai Chi legendary. I look here. It says Tai Chi classics of the legendary Grandmaster Chan Song Fong. He's a legendary. It says, once you begin to move. They're talking about our Tai Chi practice now, family. So this is very important. Welcome to the chat. I see we got a couple more people that just snuck in. Soul group, we're reading a little bit of Master Liao's Tai Chi classic translation. If you look out in the Tai Chi world, people will tell you that this is known as being one of the Tai Chi Bibles. There's other Bibles as well. When I say Bibles, I just mean very important readings. Not only very important, but very well explained. With graphics as well as words. And you always have to come back to it because it's deep and profound as well. Simple, deep, and profound. So page 87, my good brother. Tai Chi Classics number 1. This one is by the great grandmaster Chan Song Fong himself. He says, once you begin to move, the entire body must move. The entire body must be light and limber. Each part of your body should be connected to every other part. Let that settle in. Let that settle in. Profound, you see, because just knowing or just hearing the words and getting a cognitive idea, that's not gonna cut it. That's a good starting place. That's a good starting place. But we have to embody these words. He says, once you begin to move, the entire body must first of all become light and limber. He didn't say heavy. He didn't say heavy. A lot of people want to get heavy. He didn't say that. He said the entire body must become light and limber. He also says each part of the body should be connected to every other part. Now, how is that? That's what I've been teaching you along and along, slowly but surely, from the sacrum, tip of the sacrum, right? Through the coccygeal, coming up the spine, one vertebrae at a time, up one vertebrae at a time until it reaches the top of the head, talking about the flow of the energy family. Use the mind to direct the chi, down the front of the face, down, 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 making the microcosmic orbit. Now we have the macrocosmic orbit. Now the macrocosmic orbit, your brother Rob, come on in, fam, we just getting started. Macrocosmic orbit. So not only does it go up the spine and around in this circular fashion, it also brings in the extremities. That's when I tell you that it goes out the shoulder, out the elbow, out the wrist, through the palm, through the knuckles, out the fingers, out the fingertips. Whole body gotta move. Linked together, connected, like a chain, like a link on a chain. Joint by joint, segment by segment. You follow me now? You getting it? We've been getting it all this time. Now I'm letting you hear it from the philosophy side now. He says, in Tai Chi practice, the entire body should coordinate into one complete unit. One complete unit. Once you begin to move, the entire body should move. And not just the hand. Remember when I'm talking about taking out the Tai Chi ball and I said, this is not Tai Chi. This is Tai Chi. See the body? See the body moving? Right, that's what he's explaining here. He says, once you begin, the entire body should move. Not just a hand, not just a leg, not just an elbow, and so on. He says, as a beginner, I'm always a beginner, you should observe this principle all the time. He didn't say some of the time. Nope. He didn't say some of the time. He said all the time. He says the universe. Now he's talking about the universe, family. The universe. Listen in. He says the universe moves and exercises. It influences in a coordinated manner. Does it not? The entire universe moves. Everything is in orbit, moving together in harmony, in unison. Mm-hmm. He says, for example, oh, here he goes. When the earth rotates, the entire planet moves. Mm-hmm. He says, imagine what would happen if only one part of the earth rotated. While the rest of the planet remains stationary. I ain't moving. That's not Tai Chi. He says, imagine that. He says, as the system of balance and harmony was upset, drastic changes would certainly occur throughout the entire universe because it's not working in harmony. Making sense now? You see why I say connect the small self with the universal self? Mm-hmm, I thought so. A little further. He says, Tai Chi was created as a system of mental, so it begins in the mind, and physical discipline, he says, which human beings could understand and follow. That's why the martial artists started going to the temples to learn Tai Chi. They wanted to move inside of their martial art in harmony with themselves. It made them better martial artists. This is why they added Tai Chi principle, Tai Chi philosophy, to their martial arts practice. But wait, see, it's not only the martial artists that practice Tai Chi. Just a small community of martial artists. People from various backgrounds train Tai Chi, not only for fighting. That's just a small part of the study of Tai Chi. Tai Chi is a way of life that can be incorporated in anybody's life to find balance and harmony. That's the big universal Tai Chi, not the small Tai Chi. He says, almost finished, family. I mean, when you get into this, you just don't want to put it down. He says, and which is based on universal principles of balance and harmony. When you practice Tai Chi, the first basic principle that you must follow is, I hope you're listening, once you begin to move, the entire body must move as one. Let's close it down right there. You got that, right? When you practice Tai Chi, the first basic principle that you must follow is, once you begin to move, the entire body must move. Mm-hmm. Let's get it. Let's get it, fam. Come on in. Let's take flight. Let's connect the small self with the big self, the universal self. The small chi with the big chi. The small me with the big me. The small mind with the universal mind. That's Tai Chi. The small mind with the universal mind. That's Tai Chi. Let's bow in. Center yourself. Center yourself just as the earth is centered in the universe. We become our own center. You become your center. I become mine. You become your center. He become his. We all become the center of our own universe, and we work in a coordinated fashion in harmony and peace inside of the whole planetary alignment. Inside of the whole planetary alignment, we work together in harmony. That's Tai Chi. It's no antagonistic forces here, family. We're working together. As we inhale and exhale, we breathe and connect ourselves with the universal chi, prana. That's what's up. Exhale and let the tailbone go down. Let the crown point go up. Together, those things happen. And then we begin to rise up. Rise up, making an offering of ourself to the universal self. This is the offering. As we open our heart, the doorway to Tao opens for us. As we open our hearts, the doorway to Tao opens for us. You see, because a closed heart can never enter. Can never enter. But the doorway is always open to those who are simply open as well. That is the salute, that's the bow, that's the gratitude, that's the thank you to the masters who preserve the arts, the teachers and students, past, present, future, known and unknown. Thank you. Let's go right into it. When one part moves, the whole body moves with upward and downward movement. Inhale. Whole body. Inhale. Body shifting back. Joint by joint. Breath by breath. No individual joint moves independently. Whole body movement. Inhale. Let the chi move the body. The chi is the guide. The mind is the initiator. The chi is the guide. The mind is the initiator. All the way through your entire vessel. All the way through. Let the chi flow. Calm your mind. Put the mind on the belly, the center point, the dantian, the lower dantian. Whenever you find your mind wanting to wander off, bring it back to the lower dantian, the space below the belly button. Yeah, that'll get you tuned right back in. That'll tune you right back in. Mm-hmm. Inhale all the way up, upward and downward. Now you have your chi flow. Now you have your chi flow. Very good. Let the ball bounce back up with right hand on top. Right hand on top. Turn to your right. Let your weight shift over to the right side. And then you're floating now. You're floating now because one part moves, all parts move. One whole unit. When one part moves, all parts move. No stagnation, no blockages, no hindrances. Unimpeded chi flow. From right to left, from left to right. Crown point up, tailbone down. The chin is slightly tucked in, just a little bit. Just a little bit. Concave the chest. Feel your feet as they rest ever so lightly, ever so softly. Making no conflict with the earth. Relax your toes. Feel your tailbone as it extends energetically into the earth, deep into the crust of the earth, down to the very core of the earth. Allow your energetic tailbone to extend all the way down. As you turn Tai Chi ball from right to left side, now we begin to compress Tai Chi ball and split Tai Chi ball. Turn, one part moves, all parts move. Big Tai Chi ball compresses. As you sink down, tailbone is down, crown point is up. Split Tai Chi ball, left and right side. Feel your weight as it transfers from left to right side each and every time. Split all the way out to the front 45 degree corner, up. In this corner, turn, big Tai Chi ball, big Tai Chi ball. Feel the points as they come close together, the Laogong points in the center of your palms before they split apart and separate. Feel as they unite and become one. Two Tai Chi balls become one. One Tai Chi ball becomes two. As they change in yin-yang harmony, left and right side, all the way around. All the way around, as if you were moving around the perimeter of the entire universe. I mean, follow out deep into the galaxy. The soles of your feet, feel the outside soles of your feet. Feel the heels of your feet. Feel your toes. Feel inside of your body. This is internal practice. Doesn't matter what you look like. It doesn't matter what you look like. Nobody's looking. Feel. Let go of what it looks like. Only feel. Exhale, sink down. Inhale, rise up. Your body must rise and fall. Your body must rise and fall and also shift from right side to left side. sinking, splitting, rising, turning, tailbone is extended. Dragon has a tail, huh? One more time, split, rise, turn. Two Tai Chi balls become one Tai Chi ball. Compress. Split back to center. Back to center. Turn. Tai Chi. Wave hand like clouds. Wave hands like clouds. Turn. Change hands up and down. Left side to right side to left side. Breathe in, breathe out. Wave hands like clouds. One part moves, all parts move. Add a little stepping, family. Shifting right, step right. Shifting right, step right. Turn. Change hands. Shifting right. Step right. Soft. Very soft. Place the foot down on the earth very softly. Stepping like a cat. Remember, he said light and limber. Chan San Fang says light and limber. The whole body. Light and limber, floating, float, flow, and follow. Remember those three words, float, flow, and follow. Stepping leftward, float, flow, and follow, energy, follow it out. Turn, exhale, step. Notice that my feet are not touching as they come together. They're close, but not touching. Close, but not touching. Change. As I change, I pick up my foot and step. Same time. That's called coordination. That's called harmony. I say, as I change my hands, I pick up my feet and step. Same time. That's called coordination. That's called harmony. Right here, step and change. Let's go back the other way. As I change, I step. Sink down the weight on my one leg before I transfer. Sink down the weight on my one leg before I transfer. Feel your lower spine. Make sure that it is not tucked under, but straight. Your lower spine, your lumbar vertebrae. Make sure your tailbone is pointing down as you step sideways, family. Check that right now. Check your spine right now. Right there. Nice, long, beautiful spine. Nice, long, beautiful spine. Feel the weight as it transfers through from left to right, very so subtly, very subtle. You feel that? Right, feel this as well. Pay attention to those internal changes. Pay attention to those internal changes inside as your bone and your skeletal structure make adjustments, family. Not so physical, not so much muscular force. Let go of the muscles. Feel your skeletal structure. Feel your skeletal structure, family. Give it a sincere effort. Right here, feel inside. I can feel my spine. I can feel my legs. I can feel my bones in my legs. I can feel, oh, I have a very intimate relationship with my spine. I have a very intimate relationship with those little micro movements that take place inside there. Because I let go or the muscles that align my spine, the vertical muscles as well as the horizontal muscles. I'm talking about the muscles on the side of the spine and the muscles in between. Yes, those muscles, release that pressure. Release that tension. Elongate that spine. Now we're getting into the Tai Chi. Now one part moves, whole body moves. That's the part that was stuck right there. It was the spine. Let that go. Let that go. Unwind the spine. You're doing Tai Chi now, family. Inhale, let that oxygen float through now. The oxygen can float freely now. Feel the difference when you unwind the spine, how the lungs are able to fill to maximum capacity. I feel it. I feel it now. Go back the other way, family. Focus on that. It's a hell of a feeling when you can just connect with your entire being. When one part moves and the whole body moves, that's moving with power. That's moving with efficiency. That's the way we were born to move. Just like that. Oh yeah, center yourself, family. Center yourself. Come back to center. Come back to center. As we transition into... Who was that that said that? I thought somebody said play stick. I thought I heard somebody say play stick. Play stick it is. Play stick it is. Right in the transition. Right there. You see it? We're doing Tai Chi now, family, because one part moves. Whole body moves. Oh, yeah. Right there. Find your own flow, family. Don't wait on me. Don't wait on me. I'm taking my time. Find your own flow. I'll let you know when we change. Go slow. Your slow and my slow may be at a different tempo, family. Your slow and my slow may be at a different tempo. That rhymes too, fam. That rhymes. Your flow and my flow may be at a different tempo. I'm almost certain that it is, simply because our breathing rhythm is more than likely not the same. So in other words, the movement should be coordinated with the breathing rhythm, the inhalation and the exhalation, the inward movement and the outward movement. Yes, in coordination with the breath. We're getting deep now. We're getting deep now with this Tai Chi thing. The deeper we go, the more the benefits. The deeper we go, the more the benefits. Chan San Fong says, float, flow, and follow. Light and lively. Light and lively. That's what the Chi flow. That's what the Chi flow. Right there, fam. Play stick. Going right into a new transition. Right into it. Right into it. I'll wait on you. You caught up yet? Okay, let's go. Rolling elbows. Rolling elbows. Let's go. Right into it. One part moves. You got it. You know it. Like the great grandmaster says, all parts move. One part moves, all parts move. Rolling elbows. When you get the movement, follow your flow. You can leave me. Don't wait on me, fam. Don't wait on me. Now, I want you to really be sincere in this movement and make sure that it is connected. It's not just arm movement. You got to really feel for it, family. So how does this movement become a movement that is not just arm movement? I'll tell you how. I'll tell you exactly how. You listening? Okay, good, because I want to make sure you get it, fam. So remember when I say feel the muscles in your back when you move the Tai Chi ball, as you move it forward, push it from your back, pull it from your back. Here we go. Same idea, same concept. Feel your arms connected to your back. Yes, feel your arms connected to your spine, to your rib cage. Because they are. They are. They're not just connected at the shoulders. Because the shoulders are connected to the ribs. The ribs are connected to the spine. You see where we're going with this? Whole body's connected, family. One unit. Connect the arms to the back. Rolling elbows. Now you got it. Now you got it. You're doing Tai Chi, fam. You're doing Tai Chi, fam. You feel your body. I feel a floaty, bouncy sensation here. You feel that? Hold on to it. Hold on to it. Don't let it go. It's still there. That's what you should have. A floaty, bouncy feeling. Light and lively. Check it. Check that. You feel it? Okay, now hold on to it. Carry it through your form. Do you feel your arms connected to your spine? Take your time and feel it. Go ahead. Okay, now hold on to that. Hold on to it. Don't let it go. Carry throughout your form, family. Oh, you're doing Tai Chi now. You're doing Tai Chi now. Oh, I'm so happy. The deeper we go, the more the benefits. That's why I get happy. We helping people, family. We are helping people to recover their health. How could I not be excited? I told you I was excited. I told you that. I am, fam. Come back to center, fam. Come back to center. Eagle soars. The eagle takes flight. Connect your arms to your spine. Let's focus on that. Connect your arms to your spine. In the eagle here. Forget the tensing the hands. Focus on the shoulders and the arms being connected to your spine. Feel inside of your body. I want you to feel inside of your body and just focus on that. Just that alone. And then that feeling of the arms being connected to the body, I want you to hold on to that. And remember that. Awaken that feeling and go back to it every time you practice. Because it's in your memory, see? And now I'm bringing your attention to it. I'm bringing your attention to it. We're waking it back up. We're moving like a kid again. Yes, light and lively. We're moving like a kid again. That's what we do. We're rejuvenating, restoring our life force energy. Now, don't that feel good? Open the chest. Eagle soars. These are your wings, family. Connected to your spine. The arms are your wings. But they don't move independently of the body. No, that's not Tai Chi. That's not Tai Chi. They're connected to the spine. Unwind the spine and you can feel the connection of the arms to the spine. Yes, that is the way. Unwind the spine and feel the connection of the arms to the spine. Let go. Gotta let go. Gotta open the heart and take flight. Gotta get big. Gotta get real big, family. Small self with big self. Universal self. Mm-hmm. I'm sharing with you the way that has worked for me, fam. That's it. Inhale, let go. Open your heart. Travel out far. Go, let it go. Now you can feel your arms connected to your spine. Mm-hmm. One more. Follow that. Make sure you're working on that not being a physical bicep movement. Mmm. The more you let go of the biceps, you can feel it more now, right? You can feel it now more. Ah. It's so subtle. If you don't pay attention to it, you'll miss it. You'll miss it. Last one. The bear's gonna swim. The bear's gonna swim. Reverse the motion. Same feeling, different direction. Same rules apply. Well, one part moves. Ah. Whole body moves. I hear you, family. I wear glasses, but I still hear good. I hear you, family. Don't let my glasses fool you. I hear you just fine. Inhale. Let the chi travel up the spine, out of the limbs now. Out of your limbs, out of your extremities, out of the tips of your fingers. Remember the chi route? Remember the flow? As the chi comes up through the ground, into the sacrum, up your back, out of your arm from the shoulder to the elbow to the tips of the fingers, let the chi flow all the way around, all the way back. The bear swims. Open your chest, open your heart, relax, let go. That's it. A couple more, only a couple more. Inhale. Rising, crown point up, tailbone down. Same rules apply. Light and lively. All the way through. Mm-hmm. Let's take this into one of my favorites. One of my 10 favorites. You got it. Waterfall. No squatting, just standing, waterfall, all the way out, all the way up. When you get the flow, forget about me, don't wait on me. Your flow. All the way through the top, all the way down. Shifting, shifting from side to side. Move how you feel, fam. Move how you feel. See, it's not just an arm movement now. Whole body moving. Whole body. Flow. Feel good. Unwind. Waterfall. Let it go. Stir the pot. Make it heavy. Stir the pot. Right here at the belt channel. The hands are on the same horizontal plane as your waistline. Stir the pot. All the way out. All the way back, all the way around, all the way around, through the hip, out, let the chi flow, let it out. Have fun, be loose, light, and lively. Loose, light, and lively. After you stir the pot a couple times, go right into your waterfall. Split it. Play with it. Stir the pot. On your own accord, fam. Just play with it. Stir the pot. I want you to feel your upper dantian right in here, making the movement. I want you to move. I want you to awaken this upper dantian, this middle dantian. Move that with this. Move it all. Unfreeze the upper thoracic cavity. This all should be open and free to move as you everything is open, whole body move. Whole body move. Doesn't matter what it looks like. It's a feeling practice, family. Feel it and stir the pot high. Stir the pot high. Heart chakra level. Stir the pot. Use your back to stir the pot. Connect your back to your arms. Connect your spine to your arms. Yes. Connect your spine to your arms. Stir the pot. Move how you feel. Bring it back down. Settle it down. Settle it down. Settle it down. Inhale. Bring it back in dantian. Tai Chi ball inside. You need to take a little sip, family? Would you like to take a little sip? I like to take a little sip. Chi flow, upper and lower, middle, all dantians activated. If you look here, can you see it? Maybe not, but I'll bring this a little closer. So this is a piece of Sifu's artwork. Here he's representing the different dantians and the way that he feels energy is moving within. This is his expression, but if you look closely here, you can see he has a yin-yang sign embedded in here, right? This is the lower dantian, right? So you gotta learn how to move that, right? And then here, look, around the outside, got a circle, and he's got a line connecting these together inside of here, connecting those. Lower, middle, and then here's the upper dantian. You can see that very artistically displayed. Yeah, that's a Sifu's mind. Not my mind. Yeah, Sifu. Sifu Ron. So we're learning to connect our arms to our spine and our vertebrae. One reason that I'm so big on students, including myself, remember I'm always a student and I'm always learning as well, but one reason that I'm very big on students having at least a basic understanding of anatomy and physiology is simply because know thyself, first of all. Know thyself, right? I'm not saying to be a doctor or anything like that. But the more we understand our body, the way our body functions, the more we understand it, the better we're able to use our body. Don't that make sense? The more you understand about anything, the better you can use it. Right? You become more intimate with it. Becomes more yours. Right. So, quick anatomy lesson. Just on the spine, because I'm talking about it so much. So we have the spine, right? How many vertebrae do we have in the spine? This is a question for Soul Group, and we're going to get into a little bit more movement here. How many vertebrae do we have in the spine, including the coccygeal and the sacrum? Don't ask Google. We don't have time for that. If you don't know, it's fine. Don't ask Google. Type it in. Don't ask Google. How many vertebrae do we have in our spine? Because we're talking about feeling the connection of our spine to our arms. Close, Jeremy. Jeremy's the only one who went for it. I'll go ahead and say it. 36, my brother. Deanna said 26. 36. 36. Let's go. Let's get into it. I'll talk to you about it in a minute. Let's get a little movement in. I'll give you the breakdown on it. Get off of Google. Let's go. I'll break it down to you. Sink. Pick up the Tai Chi ball. Ward off. Shift forward. Shift back. Shift forward. Shift back. Turn. Shift forward. Shift back. Turn. Engage the spine. Feel the spine connected to the arms. Feel the spine connected to the arms in ward off posture. This hand hangs down naturally, heavy. This arm weighs 100 pounds right now. Real heavy. Shift forward, shift back. Empty, full. Turn back. Find your flow. Don't stop. Don't go past the tip of the toe with the knee. Everybody can do ward off. Everybody can do ward off. Inhale. Turn. Shift back. Everybody can do ward off. Feel your weight distribution changing from front leg to back leg. The majority is in my back leg. Now I'm shifting into my front leg. Maybe 70% I'll put here, or 80% in the front leg. Whatever feels comfortable. Last time. Inhale. Turn. Now watch. Step forward. Change. Shift, step back to the tip of the toe. Sink your weight down on your front leg. Shift back. Shift forward. Don't pass the front toe. When you look down the knee, don't pass the toe. The majority of the weight here, 70% or 80%. This arm is heavy. It weighs 100 pounds. Let it just dangle. Let the energy go out of the fingertips. These fingers extend to the horizon. The energy is projected out to the horizon. Same thing here, out to the ground, very heavy. Space under the armpits, little space, golf ball size. Shift forward, shift back. Everybody can do ward off. When you shift back, make sure this knee is not straight, always slightly bent. This knee is bent, but this one is slightly bent. Remember these, all these ideas. Everybody can do ward off, it's very simple. Turn. And then come turn right back. Shift forward. Shift back. Turn like the earth, you know, like the earth revolves. Turn from your center. You have become the center of the universe, your own center. Meaning your tailbone is directly down and your crown point is straight up. Let the energy extend out the tip of the toes out to the horizon. Your toenails are growing into the infinite. Your toenails. Space between your toes. Inhale. As you shift back, allowing the energy, allow it to come in. See, don't block it. We have an internal force field. Get rid of it. Remove the internal force field. So allow the universe to come in towards you as if the universe is a guest, a welcome guest of high esteem. Allow them full range of the entire palace, your entire being. Tell them, come on in. Come on in a welcoming way. You don't want to say, oh, don't. It's not like you're trying to put up a wall. You're not putting up a wall. So people confuse what ward off is. It's not a wall to keep anything out. It's a buoyant, springy energy, and that's it. But it's not a wall there, it's not a border, it's not a barrier. This is an allowing an entry. Come on in, come on in. We don't wanna put up a border or a barrier or a wall. We wanna be open. Ward off is open. It's a buoyancy. If something touches you, it'll bounce off because you're buoyant. You don't have to put up a wall. See, a wall puts up restriction and stops chi flow. Very different from being open and buoyant. Very, 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 very different. When you become a wall, you're no longer floating lightly like Chan San Fong just told us. You're no longer light and floating anymore. You're stuck, like a lot of Tai Chi people are stuck because they have a wrong idea about the way the game should be played. All right, wrong idea can take you way off track. It's about being light and lively. Not my words, we just read it in the principles, in the classics. Chan Song Fong's translation. He says light and lively. He didn't say anything about being stuck and frozen like a wall. Let's change doors. Watch. Step up. I know exactly what time it is. If you need to check out, go right ahead. We're going to be going over a few minutes here. We're going to go over a few minutes. Step back to the toe. Shift back. We got to get a little flow before we go and ward off. Some of my long timers want to take this flow practice home with them. I want to show them where the flow is at. Now that you have all this details, family, about the fingertips extending, you know, out this way and down that way, the toes extending out to the horizon. You got all these things now. Remember what your third eye is doing when you shift back? You remember what the third eye does, right? Right, as you shift back, the third eye goes back. It goes across the top and it goes back, the third eye. A lot of things. As you inhale, you allow the energy to come in. You don't block it. Take down the internal force field. All of these details, take them with you, family. Don't give them back to me. Change doors. Inhale. Exhale. Step up to change doors. Change. step back just a toe. Inhale. Exhale. Step up to change doors. Step back. This arm is heavy. Very heavy. Very heavy. Watch this. Step back to change doors. Step up to ward off. Step back to change doors. Step up to ward off. Step back to change doors. Step up to ward off. Chi flow. Step back. Step up. Step back. Step up. Step up. Step back. Step back. Step up. Chi flow. Step up. Step back. I got you on that one. Step back. Watch this. See that? See it? Forward, advancing step with the ward off, retreating 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 step with the ward off, advancing step with the ward off, advancing step with the ward off, advancing step with the ward off. So you see how you can use one posture and do so many things with it, family? You see that? Same posture, different footwork. Right. I'm not asking you to keep up with me. I just want you to see what's here. Possibilities. That's all. That way, when you review the video, you can see multiple ways to play. Watch this. Same posture. Remember the footwork I told you about? Same thing. Right. Okay, good. How was that, fam? Advanced step, side step, all those steps are there with the same posture, fam. Let's bow out. I know you got other stuff to do. Oh, good. Soul Group's here. I'm happy. At least you got it, Soul Group. A couple people checked out early. You got it. We'll talk about the spine here in a second. Let's bow out. Thank you, Sifu. Thank you, Sifu. You came through big time today. I learned a lot today. Okay, settle in, family. Settle in. I told you, we flowing and growing, huh? We flowing and growing, huh? Hang in there with me, family. Be patient with me. We're going to get it. We're going to get it. Be patient with me. All right, let's go. Exhale. Let's go home. Let's go home. Thank you, Sifu. before we go, let's center ourselves. We put in some nice work today, fam. We put in some nice work. Let's center ourselves really well here. Let's not lose that. Let's get every bit of it. Center. Tailbone, find your tailbone. Center it in. There's no rush. Let's don't rush out of this one. Settle in. Thank you, Sifu. Thank you, Tai Chi. Thank you, Tai Chi. What about that? What about that? Thank you, Tai Chi. I could never forget about you. You're always on time. Thank you, Tai Chi. Never failed me. Thank you. Thank you, Soul Group. Thank you, Soul Group. Oh, we did it with that footwork. Hey, Brother Bill, man, don't rush out, man. Hold on 1 second. Heart to heart, my brother. Give me one breath. That was one breath. Thank you, family. Thank you, Brother Bill. Thank you, Brother Gary. That was super perfect right there. I feel you, my brother. I feel you, brother. I know exactly where you at. I know exactly where you are. I know you was there. I'm gonna charge up. Oh, excuse me. So here we go. Let's talk about it. Wow, that charged up nicely. Hold on, family. Let me get this here. Hold on, fam. That charged up right quite nicely there. Yeah. Oh, I don't want to hear that. I want to hear this. This always set the mood for me. Hey, Soul Group. Thank you all very much for that. That was awesome. So let's do the math. On the spine. You like today, Sister Denise? You've been around all day as well. That's right. We did. What do we have? This early a.m. at 9, at 10. At 10. At 10, we had the flexible strength, right? And then after the flexible strength, we had the standing. Three, back to our normal three. We love to order three times a day. And I miss it when we don't, to be honest. I miss it when we don't. Let's do it. So we talked a lot today in regards to, let me turn this light off, fam. I get in trouble with all these lights on. I get in big trouble. My wife come home, boy. Yeah, so group, so did you feel, were you able to make that feeling that I was stressing today? Yes or no? Were you able to make that feeling where I was saying relax the muscles on the side of the spine? Because it's a real feeling. It's a real feeling. And when you relax the muscles, when you relax those muscles, you will feel as if when you move your skeleton, the skeleton is actually lifting the arms, and your arms feel really heavy. That's why I put so much I stressed that pretty much all day today. When we were playing Tai Chi ball, I talked about the pushing and pulling. And pulling from the back, but not by contracting the muscles. That's different. By letting go of the muscles and letting the spine make the connection. Because we're not making a muscular connection. We're making an internal soft tissue connection. You get what I'm saying? So here it is. We have, most people know about when you go, if you get into a car accident, right? What do they call that collar, that white collar that they put on your neck? What is that called? That white collar, like when people, you know, get whiplash, they call it. They get a collar, a certain collar. I want to go through this to help you remember this stuff. This is how I like to do it. Somebody tapping in. What's that collar called? Right, it's called a cervical collar or a C collar. So at the top, we have. Right, cervical with a C. We have seven cervical vertebrae. Seven. At the very top, you've heard me say it before, C1 and C2. This might be, don't worry about being as specific as I'm getting right now. C1 and C2 is the atlas and the axis. The atlas and the axis. I'm writing this down as we go. One and two. So axis, I think of what is the axis? The axis is something that something spins around on. So I'm trying to tell you my thinking, how I remember. Right? So I know it's seven in the cervical spine. Now the thoracic. So we said the cervical has seven. And specifically, I said one and two is the atlas and the axis, right? So then we're moving further down. After the first seven, we move into the thoracic, beginning with the T. Yeah, talking about the neck brace, Brother Bill. Also known as a cervical collar or a C collar. talking about the cervical spine, which is the first 7 vertebrae. So as we move further down past the cervical vertebrae, we move into the thoracic vertebrae. The thoracic vertebrae. I'm going to ask you another question at the end. Let me write this down. So the thoracic, we have 12. 12. Now, how do I remember 12? I forget what I did in my mind. I do certain things in my mind to help me remember things. You probably do the same thing. A way that you specifically like categorize information in your mind. I have these little tricks that I use to remember certain things. To remember everything, I categorize it a certain way. So when I see the T, for some reason, it jars the memory that it's 12 for me. So we have 7 at the top, and then we have 12 in the middle. So think about the middle being longer, right? The middle section of the spine is the longest part, the thorax. So the thoracic cavity is where our rib cage is connected to as well, our ribs. We have 24 ribs, right? Oh, this is how I remember it. So we have 24 ribs. We have 2 sets of 12. We have 2 sets of 12 ribs. So I know 12 ribs. I know 12 thoracic vertebrae as well. So is that making sense to you? Now I'm thinking of thoracic cavity. That's a larger cavity. I know that the thoracic cavity, it houses and it protects the lungs, the heart, and those very sensitive vital organs. And it's a big cavity, it's a big space, 12 vertebrae long. The whole, basically an entire rib cage is there, connected to that. The rib cage is connected to the thoracic vertebrae, which are pretty stable vertebrae. They don't have a lot of movement inside. Think about it, you know, they're housing our heart and our lungs, these very sensitive items. So they don't do a whole lot of moving and adjusting. Now we know our cervical, it's a lot more flexible because our head's there. You know, it gives us the ability to turn our head more. You get what I'm saying? So now let's move down further. So here now we have our lumbar. And we're familiar with the lumbar vertebrae, right? Most of us are familiar with the lumbar. People hurt their lower back. I had a situation with my L1, L2. The disc in there were, what do they call it? Herniated disc. So the disc in between the vertebrae, there's a cushion in there, and we call that a disc. Mine was herniated, meaning it was protruding. So it was out of alignment. L1, L2. Very common place that people have injuries. Now, what's also something good for you to know about L1 and L2 in regards to Tai Chi, we call that space the gate of life. Or no, the door to life. The lower is very low. It's 1 and 2. It's 5 of those. So now we got 7 on the top, 12 in the middle, and 5 on the bottom. That's 24. Right? 12 plus 12 is 24. You still following me, family? So now, below, we're down to the lumbar now. So now below the lumbar, remember I said it was 36. Below the lumbar, we have our sacrum. I talk about it all the time, right? The tip of the sacrum, the very tip of the sacrum. How we want to focus on bringing the energy up that. So think about it like this. The sacrum, it's not going to be a long segment of ribs. I said ribs. It's not going to be a long segment of the spine. It's going to be very short if you think about the location of it. You get what I'm saying? Right. So that's five. Five. Mm-hmm. So where are we at now? That's 29. So now we have the very last segment, which I say the tip of the coccyx. So the coccyx itself has four. So does it make sense now that we're getting from a very large thoracic region? That's the largest part of our spine. Not only large in the number, but also large in size. You get what I'm saying? And if you think about this, think about how large it is, because it's so important. It's not that the other part's not important, but it houses some very sensitive, the thorax we're talking about, it houses some very, very sensitive anatomy, is the word I was looking for. That makes sense? Is that making sense, fam? Okay. Oh, y'all good. I'm just talking. We just talking. I'm talking to my group. My soul group. Nah, it's right here. So we're at, yeah, I lost count. 7 cervical, 12 thoracic, 7 + 5 for the lumbar, that's 24. 12 + 12. Now we have 5. How do I remember that? When I think of the sacrum, for some reason, 5 just jumps in my head. I don't know why. I don't know how you're going to remember it. That makes sense? And now you have your cervical. So 7 + 5 + 12 = 24. + 5 = 29. And then we're down to the tip of the coccyx. So the tip of the coccyx is very, very small. You ever hear somebody breaking their tailbone? Yeah, so people break their tailbone. They don't get their tailbone fixed. So you can think about it. It's important, but it's also very small. So how many are we up to now? That's 29 + 4 = 33. And that's exactly what it is, man. I said 36, it's 33. It's 33. That's the 33 right there. Let's break it down again. So we have 7 cervical, which are at the top. 12 thoracic, which are in the middle. We drop down lower to the lumbar. Now the lumbar are actually very large as well. Although there's only five, they're very large. But think about this. They're large in like the bone capacity, like the thickness of the bone. Reason being is because it bears so much weight. All of our body weight goes down until that lumbar region. So it's heavy. So it has to be strong to support that. You get what I'm saying? So you kind of following some of the meaningfulness of the anatomy structure, why it's put together, the way it's put together. So cervical is 7. Remember the C collar, the neck brace. Thoracic, 12. T with 12. Yeah, T for 12. Duh. That's how I remembered it. Remember, I said I couldn't think of why. That's why. T for 12. So that'll help you remember it now. And then you're going to hear me say, duh. That's going to help you remember it even more. So 7 plus 12 plus 5 is 24. Now sacrum. Sacrum has 5. We're up to 29 now. 24 plus 5 is 29. Yeah, in the spine. Because this is Tai Chi. The spine is very important to Tai Chi. We're talking about how the arms are connected to the body today.
She knows.
I know she does. So now we got 29 plus, I always say, the very tip of the coccyx. So the coccyx has 4. So now we got 33. Isn't 33 another number? Yeah, master number 33. Master teacher number 33. So you see how all these things are connected? I think they talk about 33 in the Bible as well. I don't want to go down that road, but Jacob's ladder or something like that? I don't know. Sometimes my mind goes off on tangents. For some reason, that's ringing the bell, fam. That makes sense to anybody? Any kind of parallel in there with the number 33? I know that's the master teacher number. So this is going to help you remember the spine and the organization of the spine. And how the arms, I was telling you to relax the muscles that are on each side of the spine. So when you relax those muscles, you can feel your connection to your body. Remember, when one part moves, all parts move. But if we're tense, we can't feel our connection. And then we start using our muscles, more physical muscles, to move the body. Well, we don't want to do that in Tai Chi. We want to let go of those big, bulky muscles. She following you like that? You get what I'm saying, fam? My herbs are always on point. Yeah. This is eucalyptus or something. That's funny how she runs over there like that. Yeah, so I just thought we should go down that line, fam. We should go down that road. Because you know I'm always talking about anatomy when I'm giving instruction. I want everybody to at least have an idea of what I'm talking about, where I am. And if you're serious about the art, if you're serious about learning about your body, don't you want to know this information? I know I do. And somebody else does as well. I just help somebody with that. I learned something myself. I know that sounds a little selfish. Hey fam, I gotta go. I gotta charge up, take a little break. And actually, I got a private group lesson coming up. It's gonna be nice. We got little soul groups forming, got other people forming soul groups. And I got a group of 3 or 4 that's coming in with Brother Micah today. Soul group, yeah, he invited 3 or 4. I sure was.
I think I remember seeing you in the morning.
That's why I came in there. How'd he get in there? I was charging. Okay, so he's bringing 3 or 4 family members over today, and we're zooming it. Look at that, 33 showed up again. Boom, look at that. It's 333 right now. We're just talking about, remember I talk about numbers and how the universe talks in numbers? We're talking about 33 vertebrae, so now it's 333. I don't know. That's just how I am. I like to play around with numbers. And I always say, look, the universe is speaking, and I believe it. I'm out, family. I love you. I'm out. It was a good day today. We did 3 today. That was awesome. Good lessons today. If you didn't get to go through the whole lesson today, you missed a good lesson today. I just thought I'd share that with you. Ask Soul Group. We had a phenomenal lesson today. I don't even remember what it was. That's when I know it's good. When I don't remember what we did, it was a good lesson. So that's the spirit, when the spirit takes over. That's the chi flow, family. Let me go. I'll talk to y'all all day. I love you guys. Peace.